Hi guys. In this tutorial, it's going to be kind of a short one. I guess I'm going to show how to create fixed positioned elements in Figma, which are also called sticky elements, meaning that they stay at the same position when we are scrolling. Okay. So for the sake of this tutorial, I've created a very basic website layout. I did it really quickly, not too much into it, and a kind of a mobile screen layout. And let's see exactly how it goes. So, if I am clicking this frame and I'm clicking the play button to see it, it's already opened. Let me just for a minute hide the Figma UI. So this is what I'm seeing. I can scroll and then, oh, sorry. I need to do it like this. Yep, that's more like it. And when I'm scrolling, so you will see that this header, okay, the header is usually the kind of like, a navigation bar that is almost in any website, some kind of a navigation, which usually is on top of the website. And sometimes, or a lot of times, it is sticky, meaning it stays in the same position when we are scrolling the website. Okay, so now it's not configured as fixed position, so it just scrolls. And when we scroll up again, we can see it again. Very simple and easy thing I can do is just click on the header. Okay, that's my header. And I can click here, fix position when scrolling. Now, the moment I do that, you will see that Figma actually now divides the elements that we have on the screen into sections, actually. We have the fixed elements section. These are the ones that will be in fixed position, and we have the scrolls. The scrolls are the ones that are scrolling. Okay, so if we look at our website again now, we will see that now when I scroll, my header stays at the same position. Okay, it stays sticky. Now it is a sticky element. Okay, so that was very quick and easy, nice and great. Now, the other screen that I have chosen to show it is the mobile screen. The mobile screen, we have a better way of just kind of sticking it at the height that we want to see it, and then making sure that it's always on the bottom of our screen. So if I will put, by the way, this is the way to switch from a not in a mockup view and make it in a mobile mockup view. Okay, here I can click show prototype settings, and here on the device, if my device is 375 of width, I will choose the same device here. Okay, I will choose a device with a width of 375 iPhone. I mean, the name of it doesn't really matter at all. Notice that the iPhone 13 mini and the iPhone 11 Pro is actually the same size. Okay, but it doesn't really matter. Well, the only thing that matters to us is the 375 of width. And if I will choose this one, okay, so now I'm seeing the website inside a mobile, which is cute, but it's not exactly what I meant. I will add a flow here actually, and I can just press play, and that's it. Okay, so you see that now actually it's in the right place. I mean, our bottom navigation bar, which is this one, okay, the one that I've created for this website. Sorry for this tutorial. So now it's in the right place actually where it should be. Okay, but that means that I'm kind of guessing, okay, or let's say that if I want to kind of aim it to wherever it needs to be, sometimes I don't know exactly. So yes, I can put it, let's say it's here, and I can click on it to be fixed position when scrolling. Okay, so now you will see that when I look at it again, it's not exactly in the right place. And then if it's not exactly in the right place, I need to kind of play with it and, you know, kind of target the exact place that it needs to be. Well, Figma did it in a much better and great, very great way. The way that we can do it is we can keep this as a fixed position element. We can put this all the way to the bottom. Okay, by the way, you know what? I can just take it, not this one. I can just, where is my bottom navigation bar? No, where is it? Yeah, okay. I'm gonna take it outside for a minute. I'm just gonna place it. You know what? It doesn't matter, honestly. Wait, it's just kind of like playing with me. Okay, so this is going to be here. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this screen actually longer. Okay, and then I can just put my bottom navigation bar here at the bottom. Now, I'm gonna make it a fixed positioned element. And the other thing that I'm going to do is with the constraints, and I'm reminding, by the way, I do have a tutorial about constraints if you're not really familiar with it or you don't really know what I'm talking about and what does actually constraints do. So here with the constraints, notice that now it has that dotted, you see that dotted blue line, it means that is chained or kind of constrained to the top of the frame. If I will click here and change it to the bottom of the frame, that means that the frame is our screen. And that means that if it is constrained to the bottom of the screen, it means that it's always gonna be at the bottom of our screen, and we don't have to kind of like, you know, aim or target or calculate exactly where does it need to be. So look, now you see it's exactly where we want it to be, and I can just, my scroll is working and this element stays at the place exactly where we want it. For example, I'll give another example. Let's say that I need to add, or I want to add, a floating action button, the one that actually you will see sometimes more in Google layouts. But let's make one like this. So I'm gonna take, let's say, an ellipse. Oh, it's in the auto layout, that's why it does it like that. I'm gonna create one outside, and actually I will create it in a frame. Yeah, I can create it in a frame. Let's make this frame, I think that this is a good size of it. Okay, and I'm reminding you that I can give a frame round corners, okay? And of course, give it effects like on a shape. So I'll do it like this, and I will give it this color, and I will make something like that, I guess is good. And okay, and I will duplicate it 90%, 90 degrees, make it a group, and that's a plus icon, which is great. And this I will call, in a shortcut, FAB, which means floating action button. And I can also give it a shadow. Why not? Let's give it a shadow. It's for free, so we can use it. Why not? Okay, and here you see I don't want my by the way, a little trick. So you see here I have this elements in an auto layout, okay, If you guys are not so familiar with auto layout, I'm going to have a tutorial soon on auto layout and make it kind of like more clear. Anyway, if you are familiar with the auto layout, then you can just, while you start moving it, sorry, press the space bar, and then you can just place it freely on your frame without making it enter into the, I mean, automatically enter into your auto layout. And look at that. So this button, actually, this floating action button is placed here at the bottom of the frame, and I can give it a fixed position when scrolling. Oh, it's not inside the frame, that's why. I was wondering why I don't have a fixed position on it. This is the iPhone 13 mini. Okay, yeah. So I'm just going to drag it and put it here. By the way, I can put it in the fixed section, and then it's already a fixed position element. You see, I just dragged it and dropped it here where it says fixed. That means that I'm telling Figma this will be a fixed positioned element. Okay. Now, if I don't switch here the constraints to the bottom of the screen, what happens now is I'm not going to see it because it's fixed position and it's all the way down there where the end of the frame is, and I will never see it. Even when I scroll, it's in a fixed position down there. So I'm going to switch here to bottom. That means that is constrained to the bottom of the frame, meaning the bottom of our screen, and now you're going to see it. Now you're supposed to see it. We actually don't. Let's press play again. Maybe we need to refresh it. So let's do that. Why we don't see it? What's going on here? Let me see. Let me understand what happened here. Okay, so this is our floating action button. Fixed position. It's a on the bottom of our screen, and basically we are supposed to see it, which is pretty weird. Let's try that again. Okay, so the only problem was that refresh. It didn't really refresh my screen. Anyway, that's kind of a bug. You know what? I found out that actually when you work on the web interface, these things, they almost never happen. It only happens on the desktop app. Kind of like a red flag to Figma a bit. Maybe, I don't know, things that need to be done better here. But anyway, okay, so this is our floating action button. And as you see, when we are scrolling, so the logic is that we are determining, actually deciding where, okay, is it going to be placed when our screen ends. Okay, so this is kind of like a setup that I had here, the bottom navigation bar and the floating action button, etc. Even here, let's say on my website, on my most beautiful website in planet Earth, don't say it's not. Anyway, I'm hearing you. Anyway, so if I want to do, let's say, kind of a, you know, these kind of like chat bubbles that you have sometimes on website that you can click and, you know, chat and contact with someone. So let's create a button like that. Let's see. Let me make it the same way. I'll make a frame and put it here. Let me see the size of it. Of course, this is too big. Let's give it kind of like a 60 by 60. And let me see if it's good enough. I'm going to check here. I'll make it even a bit bigger. Something like that. Let me see. Yeah, I guess that's okay. Something like that. And we can place it kind of here, and I will give it the same the same color, and I will create even maybe a quick chat icon. Maybe, yeah, I can do this pretty quickly. Let's do something like that and give it a And don't worry, we're gonna fix it. It's not gonna look that weird. We're gonna fix it now. Give it a something like that. Yeah, I guess that's for this now. It's pretty okay. And we'll give it kind of a white background, and we can give it even a bit of a corner radius there. Yeah, that's good. And we'll give it kind of something like that. Yeah, that's pretty good. Second. Oh, it keeps duplicating my colors, and that's not what I want. And okay, good. So that's good. And we have this. Let's make it a group. I'm not giving a kind of like great names here, but it doesn't matter. Let's just align it right now like this. And that's pretty cool. Okay, good enough for us. And we're going to call this chat. And we have this beautiful chat button. Let's give it even a shadow. Why not? Houston, we have a shadow. Okay, so here, as I said, again, fixed position element, fixed its position. So now you see, it's kind of like, yeah, it does stay at the same place, and I can keep on aiming it. Maybe, no, I need to put it in the, let me put it like that, and I can keep on trying and kind of aim it to where it needs to be. You see what I'm talking about? Okay. Instead of that, I can just take it and put it, once again, I don't want it in our auto layout. Yeah, it's kind of like, it's kind of like playing with me. Let me grab it again, and I will go from the outside, and I will do that like this. I will put it here. Yeah. So we have it right here. I remind you that this is the end of our screen. Okay. And I'm just putting it wherever I want it to be, kind of, proportional with the same space all the time to the bottom and to the right side. So again, constraints, bottom and to the right, and boom, we don't have it anywhere. Let's put it like, let's see now. Oh, because I didn't give it a fixed position, in my opinion, not yet. Where is it actually? Oh, it's inside the footer. I don't want it inside the footer. Just put it here. Yeah. Okay. And now we have it. Ta-da! Yeah, now it's okay. And it's exactly where we want it and need it to be. Okay. So this is kind of like the best way of doing it. And actually the constraints work really great. So we have the header, we have the chat, and that is pretty awesome. That's it. I guess that's pretty clear and understandable for now. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and I hope it was helpful and knowledgeable, and that is the whole idea. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next tutorial. And I'm saying again, if you didn't see the tutorial about the constraints, I suggest you do. And I would be more than happy if you can also hit the subscribe button and be aware and informed about the next great tutorials that will follow. Thank you so much, and bye for now, guys. Thank you.